we've transported 1,917 great Central Missourians to Washington.
Personal way, what your service has meant to them.
It is my esteemed pleasure to present to you the 2014 Honor Ball Mail Call.
Good evening. I'm Hal Dooley, and I guess I'm the first one to read his letter. First of all, I want to let you know how honored I am to be here to share with this program. And I hope the ride continues so long as there are deserving men and women outstanding. My letter is one of remembrance, one that was written a long time ago to a fellow Marine who I went through boot camp with, later served in Vietnam. The letter was written at a time when Vietnam veterans were facing extreme challenges returning from the battlefield. Dear Jimmy, it's been a long time, 47 years to be exact, that we shared Iraq at the Marine Corps boot camp in San Diego. Last time I saw you was at Da Nang. We were in Da Nang and you were headed to the fire base at Con Tien, south of the DMZ. I heard you made it back, got out after your hit and returned to St. Louis. It was a tough, challenging time returning to the world. Nobody really cared what we had done, and we felt the rejection. Over the years, I've come to realize, as have many in our society, that it was the Washington self-serving politicians and bureaucrats that caused the mess we had to endure. Such a travesty and waste of humankind. We will always feel the pain of loss. But we made it, and now we should stand proud and join our brothers who have been in the Revolutionary War up through Korea, and our sons and daughters who understand duty, honor, and country, and continue to fight for the principles that underpin our freedoms and opportunities that guide our way of life. God bless those who are serving our country today. These principles for which we fought, not only for us, but for all people, have allowed us to live freely and prosper in the greatest country in the world. The Vietnam veteran has become a rare breed and has gathered strength and resolve over the years, not only shaped by the challenges, hardships, and pains brought by fighting an unwinnable war halfway around the world, but continuing to fight for acceptance back in the world from this misinformed society that was brainwashed into thinking we were the blame. We're, in fact, each of us accepted the duty and served with honor. We never lost a battle, yet in the minds of many, we lost the war. The wall is symbolic of our commitment to that resolve. So today, Jimmy, as we go forth, retired from our labors and surrounded by family, we should stand tall and know that we have played a vital role in sustaining the principles that have made our country strong. Yes, our country faces. Thank you.
And we have transported 1,917 great Central Missourians to Washington.